This is WPSL Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast.
At WPSL. Views expressed on the following program are not necessarily those of WPSL. However, you're encouraged to like and share them on Facebook. Go ahead and subscribe while you're at it to WPSL TV on YouTube. And then share it on Facebook with all your friends, because it's time for Joanne's Nutrition World to proudly bring you a weekly adventure. Joanne's World of Nutrition. And it's hosted by the proprietor of Joanne's Nutrition World, Joanne Seeger.
Hello, everybody. Happy Thursday. Well, what an intro. Thank you very much.
No problem.
I hope everyone's having an amazing day. I feel great today. I love those days that you just wake up with lots of energy and clarity and just, you know, you're ready to tackle on the world. So it's luckily one of those days for me. So hopefully my audience gets the benefit of it.
Me too, strangely enough. You know, I should be in misery, but I'm not. And I refuse to be.
Well, I'm glad. Refuse it.
Works great for me.
Don't let it in. Don't let it in.
I was smiling the other day and somebody said, "You're in denial." And I said, "No, I'm not."
Well, it's so funny because sometimes people want to remind you why you should be in pain. And it's like, yeah. Hey, dude, I'm feeling good. Leave me alone. Well, everyone, thank you so much for spending some time with me this morning. Welcome any newbies to the show. And we need to start the morning with our breathing exercise. So we have our expert counter in the house.
Oh,
Cliff,
cool.
Thank
Where's
you
that?
Very much.
Oh,
yeah,
me. Oh, you're talking to me. Okay.
And so how about we do three rounds? Okay. And again, if you're a newbie, super simple. We want you to breathe in through your nose for 5, hold for 5, and exhale for 5. And let's do that 3 times.
And what we're teaching you to do is something that you can do all you want.
That's
in your
right.
Spare time.
It's free and available to all, and proven results.
Yes.
So, ready? Let's exhale out any negativity,
out.
Anxiety, okay. Depression, fear. Let's
let
breathe it all out.
Go.
Okay.
Okay.
Here
there
we
it
go.
Goes. Let it out. And get ready for through the nostrils as we begin. Go ahead now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. Release. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. Release. 2, 3, 4, 5. One more time. 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 2, 3, 4, 5. And release. 2, 3, 4, 5.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. I love doing the breathing exercise, and it definitely ties in with today's show. We are going to talk about vamping up the immune system and preventing colds and flus this season. Next week, normally Dr. Ravi is my guest the third Thursday of every month, but he's going to help me out next Thursday. We are going on a little northern vacation. So he's going to be talking about part 2 of this show, which is cancer and the immune system. You know, sometimes we kind of tread lightly on the cancer subject. There's a lot of information out there that seems when we try to help our customers with this information, this skepticism, because it's a scary subject. But Dr. Ravi is not scared, and he's going to tell you about all the amazing information that's out there on fighting cancer and or treating it naturally when you get it. So don't miss next week's episode with Dr. Ravi. All right, so cold and flu season. It's another subject that, unfortunately, a lot of people are really scared about. Sometimes they hear things on social media or see things, and they let it go to heart, and it just right away grips them, and they get nervous that they're going to get it. So they consider getting the flu shot, and I just want my listeners to really do the homework and take their health into their own hands. So, for instance, you can go right to the Center of Disease Control's website. So it's cdc.gov. And every week they update it to the flu and what's happening around the country. So right now, the flu is on low. Like, so there's very little threat of the flu for real in our area. Now, if you were to walk around some of the drugstores in town, you would think just the opposite. They're suggesting that you get the flu shot. There's signs everywhere, even in the parking lot, even on the streets as you drive through. And now there's boosters that you can buy too. Just so you know, you can get accurate information from the CDC website that clearly states in the trials, there was only 10% effectiveness with the vaccines. And even in those statistics, it's a strain that's not even affecting us this year. So in other words, that means it's not even going to be helpful and it could even hurt us. That's why those nasal flu vaccines were so dangerous, because it was the live virus and making us contagious to the people around us. So really, just educate yourself. Do not let the cashiers at a drugstore give you your health information or, you know, persuade you. They actually get a sheet of how to sell you on the shots. And a lot of times, too, it's some people are like, well, I got mine for free. It's no such thing as free. There's always, it's either an add-on sale to a treatment you're getting, or the side effects are going to end up costing you more, like getting the flu. So again, if you need the accurate information week by week, the CDC posts activity levels. Like right now, the map is pretty much totally green for Florida. We have no issue, very low rates right now. So you want to really do your homework. And if you have a compromised immune system, you get colds easily, or you don't feel well in general on a day-to-day basis, you are the last person that really should get the flu shot, because then even that could compromise you and get you worse. So today's show, I'm going to try to give you very inexpensive, easy things that you can do to get your body as strong as possible for whatever might come your way. I don't want to say like, you know, oh, you're definitely going to come across the flu or a cold this season. I don't want that negativity to be out there. But just in day-to-day terms, you should be the strongest version of yourself, so that way you can feel the best and really just have an awesome day, you know, living in the moment and making the best out of each day. So that's definitely should be your goal. I think sometimes the information that's out there about health in general is extremely overwhelming. When I'm watching TV and I see the commercials, it's extremely, extremely upsetting to me when I see the commercials and they list all the side effects that are after the pharmaceutical suggestion. And then I see that even people I know that are smart and they make really good choices in life are taking these drugs. So I wonder where the gap is. Why are people still taking these drugs even though they advertise all these horrible, horrific side effects? And the only thing that I can believe is just because they want to feel better, or they're super scared of what might happen if they don't. So if you are feeling that that's you, that you just want to feel better, or you're just really nervous if you don't take this drug, what might occur? Keep in mind that there is so much information available to show you alternatives that are safe with no side effects, and also the same materials out there to prove that most of these drugs, the side effects outweigh any good that they usually do. So I know I sound like I'm really against Big Pharma this morning, but that is my stance. I've always been against Big Pharma, and I just feel like it's making people sicker and sicker, and they're just on these roller coasters of more drugs. So to be clear, the information is out there. It's not like secret. It's not hidden. You can get all the side effects right there with your prescriptions and the ingredients listed, like the vaccines now are disclosing that they have really horrible ingredients in all the vaccines coming from animal strains and very dangerous material. And I will have a health expert on my show once he comes in town in January that's going to be talking about this subject in detail. All right, so cold and flu season. So here's the first things that you should do to get your body stronger. And these might seem really basic, but just like if you're building a new home, you want to first start with the foundation. You know, you wouldn't choose dirt, right? You would choose cement, and you would make sure it was framed properly. And it's the same thing with your health. Instead of like going out there and buying all those trendy things and, you know, going to a store and maybe getting 10 inexpensive supplements because that's what was listed on social media, just invest some time in one really high quality supplement or food that you really will stick to that's going to make a difference. It's better to go for quality versus quantity, okay? And there are a lot of supplements that are out there that are deceiving people and tricking. So go with brands or stores that you trust. The big box stores are only there for profit. They do not have the people to help you. So whether you shop at my health food store or your local health food store or you have an online store that you trust, just please, quality over price and quantity. That's critical. I see all the time on Facebook and other social media, oh, buy three, get three free. And, you know, they promise everything, but yet no one even checks ingredients. And sometimes on these sites, the ingredient panels are not even offered. You should really stay away from them, okay? All right, so the basics to start your immune system kicking in and preventing colds and flus is actually sleep. So that's the most important basic step to vamping up your immune system. And I know many people that have trouble sleeping. And they take sleep medicine, which unfortunately has other side effects that could hinder their immune system. So one of the ways that you can really help your sleep is by making sure your room is completely dark, no lights on at all, no devices, no TV, no iPads, no laptops, no iPhones or phones. Keep the technology away from the bed. That's critical. I know I have a habit because I put my alarm on my phone, on my nightstand. It's really important if you have disrupted sleep that you keep the technology away. Another study showed that not to use your technology for an hour before you go to bed. So the hour before you go to bed, and again, you're trying to gear towards 7 hours sleep minimum, 8 is even perfect. So an hour before bed, maybe you can go into your bedroom, make sure that the lights are all off, the technology is put away, you take some nice deep breaths, and you turn the noise of the day off, do some deep breathing exercises. I also think that indoor air pollution is really disruptive to sleep. So that's another problem we have with sleep and our immune systems in general. When the bedroom air or the air of the house is so polluted, but you don't even know. For Floridians, it's really challenging for us. We're still in very warm months. We're using our air conditioning every day for months now. It's, you know, hot, muggy outside, so we're not even thinking about opening up doors and windows yet. And all that indoor air pollution really puts a damper on our immune systems and disrupts our sleep. So if you can, if you're not able to bring fresh air in, check what's inside your house. Make sure you're not using candles. Candles are extremely toxic. There are, again, just like supplements, there are deceiving candles that you find in most stores that will say, oh, made with soy wax. So everyone assumes because it says soy wax, oh, it must be natural. No, it's just another gimmick to make you think it's natural. Turn over the ingredient panel on the back of the candles or on the bottom and check the ingredients. Is it artificial fragrance? Most people can tell if you just sample the smell at the store and you open the top. If it's overwhelming, you know it's synthetic. Natural smells are never overwhelming. That's why some people don't choose to buy them, because they feel like they won't mask odor in their home, or they won't be strong enough or pleasant enough. But it's really not true. The natural candles, even though they're made with natural essential oils, the smell is wonderful, but it's subtle. And it just carries over gently throughout your home and doesn't overwhelm it. But again, it's not putting carcinogenics in the air, toxic fumes that are invisible to you. But after a period of time, you're breathing this into your sinuses, to your lungs, and it's getting into you on a cellular level. And there are many studies showing that all these artificial smells and petroleum byproducts are really dangerous to your health. So that would be the easiest step is to check for indoor air pollution. So other than candles, the next worst offender, if not worse than candles, is those plug-ins. There's a lot of brands now that give you these different smells. Oh my God, there's like 100 different smells. You plug them in. They're extremely overwhelming and extremely toxic. If I step into a waiting room or a home that has a plug-in, within 5 seconds of stepping into that area, I can sense the toxic petroleum smell. It's extremely overwhelming to me. So you want to avoid buying them. And now I have a house that has dogs in it, so I know what it's like to want to mask odors. But I use essential oils and natural essential oils, only high quality, because again, they're making cheap fake oils as well with chemicals. So natural essential oils and diffusers. I use natural incense. I have a natural spray that I sell at my store that comes in lemon, lime, or orange. That's completely natural. And that's wonderful. If you spray it near your intake for your air conditioner, it makes the odor of the house nice. It actually cleans the air. And citrus, especially lemon and lime, is antibacterial and great to clean out your ducts and keep your home healthy and safe and not create indoor air pollution. So you really want to look out for that. And also, too, besides candles and toxic essential oils, the non-natural ones, okay? Natural essential oils are amazing, and they have a lot of health benefits. But the ones that are synthetic will hurt your health, not help it, okay? It's also to bleach. You need to get the bleach out of your home. I have been guilty of using it for extreme emergencies. There are some times when you've tried every other cleaning product and it doesn't work. But the hydrogen peroxides, the baking sodas, the vinegars, there are so many natural, amazing cleaners now in every store. You want to switch to natural cleaning products. Even if they're in bottles, these toxic ingredients gas off from their plastics. So it's not, and especially if you put them like in the garage to store them and they get warm, they'll gas off more. So we already are dealing with our furniture gases off from synthetic materials, all the fire repellent sprays that they use on our furniture and furniture polish, that's extremely toxic too. So please don't use that. These things gas off and cause indoor air pollution, and it really makes it difficult to have a quality sleep. And you can take all the drugs you want to help you sleep, but if you have indoor air pollution and you're breathing this in every night, you will have disrupted hormonal patterns, and disrupted sleep. So you really want to be careful of that. The next real basic thing to get your immune system strong and prevent colds and flus is washing your hands. Now, the only problem I have with this message that is in across our school systems and a doctor's office, it is critical that we wash our hands and keep our hands clean, but not with antibacterials. Luckily, they are getting the message out that all these antibacterial wipes and soaps and sprays are actually very dangerous now. They have chemicals in them that are carcinogenic, and so they've been used long enough that now they are causing a serious problem. All the different strains of like bacteria and germs are getting stronger because of us using all these antibacterials. So you want to just wash your hands with basic soap and water. I love, absolutely love Dr. Bronner's products. This line called Bronner's is sold everywhere. It doesn't matter if you're shopping at a regular store or at a health food store. But Bronner's makes Castile soaps that come peppermint, eucalyptus, lavender, almond, and they're made with natural essential oils to give them these wonderful smells, and they're concentrated and so affordable. You can buy one big bottle and then fill up all your little hand soap containers. You can use it to wash dishes, wash clothes. Some people even brush their teeth with it. Because remember, your skin is the largest living organ. What you put on your skin comes into your body. I think it takes like 8 minutes, a study said, that something from the outside coming into your body. That's pretty fast. So you want to wash your hands with something that's not toxic, but will help, like, you know, clean up any germs that might be hiding under your fingernails. And you can just buy like a little nice bristle brush to keep by your sinks to wash under your nails. So that's, again, these are real basic things. You don't need to buy fancy stuff. You just need the basics. So warm soap and water, getting the house indoor air pollution cleaned up. And then the next real easy one is drinking water. Like, how easy is that, right? But so many people are not doing it. So if you're listening and you're thinking, I just absolutely don't like drinking water, then just do high content vegetables. Normally I would tell people fruit, but our fruit today is so sweet and filled with so much sugar that people just kind of overconsume it. But if you can keep in control of your sugar content, then, you know, some nice apples, especially right now in apple season, Granny Smith apples, those are really yummy and filled with water. So you can have an excuse to eat more fruits and vegetables because you want to get that water into your body. But don't be fooled. If your body doesn't have water, it cannot heal itself. The body wants to work these miracles, but it needs the basic tools to do it. And water is one of them. I love to put lemon and lime in my water because when I put lemon and lime in my water, not only does it give it a very nice flavor, but lemon and lime, the ash of it, so after it digests, is very alkalizing. So even though it seems very acidic to the tongue, inside our digestive system, it's alkalizing. And that's really good. No human disease can exist in an alkaline environment. So if you put lemon and limes in your water every time you drink it, you're making your immune system stronger, you're making your body more alkaline, and you're enjoying a very nice smell and taste, which is great. Aromatherapy has been proven to uplift moods, make you feel positive, especially citrus like orange, lemon, and limes. They actually say those are the feel-good smells that make you feel joyous. And I don't know, but that word joyous sounds great, especially this day and age when we're kind of anxious and scared. And I saw on a documentary, it was just terrible. They said that we're in an epidemic state of loneliness, that because of social media and devices that we're isolating ourselves, and that's the worst thing for your immune system. the areas around the world that show the best health and the longest lifespans are extremely social. They're always with community and friends, and they're positive. And so it begins with that. So you definitely want to get the negativity out of your day. And when we come back from the break, again, I'm just going to be talking about real basic things here to vamp up your immune system, to prevent colds and flus, and just to feel the best you can each and every day. So we will be right back. Thank you so much for listening.
Guiding the Treasure Coast in health, one person at a time. That's their motto at Joanne's Nutrition World, Suite 121, in the historic Arcade Building on US 1, downtown Fort Pierce. Joanne brings more than 25 years of experience in the natural health industry, right here to you. Take advantage of this free personal guide to wellness and good health. Meet with Joanne herself and get started. Nutrition World always provides you with the hottest new product lines, natural and homeopathic remedies, herbals, and best of all, expert advice from the people who care. Call Joanne at 464-3598, 464-3598, and learn the correlation between diet and great health. Stop in today. The expert guidance to health is always free at Nutrition World. Nutrition World, Suite 121 in the Arcade Building, US 1, downtown Fort Pierce. Join Dr. Rob Sellards from Florida Orthopedic Specialists right here for Bone Talk, Wednesday mornings at 10 a.m.
We'll answer all of your orthopedic questions as well as medical questions. You can also reach us at bonetalkradio@gmail.com, where you can submit your questions and suggestions.
It's Bone Talk every Wednesday morning from 1590 WPSL. Talk of the Treasure Coast for 25 years and counting.
This is WPSL Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast.
And you can continue your breathing exercises throughout the whole show if you like. You'll feel better afterwards, but don't do it while you're driving because you might tend to close your eyes. Yeah. Well, you can do it if you can do it with your eyes open, your breathing exercises. Time now to get back to Joanne's World of Nutrition. A great show going today. Once again, here's your host, Joanne Seeger.
Hey, everyone. Happy Thursday. Thank you so much for spending some time with me this morning. I am so grateful for all my listeners. And if there's any newbies, welcome, welcome. Today we're talking about preventing and getting the body super strong to fight any cold or flus that come your way. I know that there are definitely challenges, you know, whether you have young ones in school or your grandkids are coming over and bringing their gook from school. And it does seem that when you're around someone right away, like you're like, oh, are you sick? And you start getting nervous, you know, like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna get it. But we do need to think preventatively with this topic, really with any topic, but especially this, because once we get sick, it's definitely harder to get rid of it. So you want to think preventatively. And the steps that I'm trying to go over today, to me, are really easy to do each and every day. And the supplements that I'm going to bring up on the second half of the show, I feel are things that I've been using for over 20 years. My children have always used them. And I try again, I'm not trying to sound boastful, but my kids, you know, I don't use any normal medicines that you would find at a drugstore or antibiotics. I always give them natural remedies because I believe in making the body stronger to fight what's happening then and what could happen in the future, because it is shown that our antibiotic uses are not making us stronger. They're making us weaker. And for the most part, there really is no drug or antibiotic that you can use for the flu that's effective with no side effects. So these natural measures really are the main line of defense against getting sick. Now, we do the breathing exercise every Thursday morning on the show, and I never want you to take that breathing exercise lightly. They have done so many studies now showing that deep breathing exercises, along with either meditation or prayer or what they're calling spiritual time, is more effective in healing the human body than any natural or drug medicine. I mean, I think that's absolutely incredible. So it's free. So we can't use the excuse, I can't afford it. We can all make time for it. Matt and I, we use this app. I feel like I should be getting some, you know, money from them. I talk about this so often. It's an incredible app called Sync Tuition. So if you do have a smart device, you can download this app, and Sync Tuition, it's 25 minutes of a leaded meditation. You don't have to do anything but listen, and it's worth 4 hours of meditation. It works on rhythms, gamma waves, 3D sound effects. It's absolutely cool. And so you definitely want to look into that. If you have no idea where to begin, and you've tried meditation before and it just felt unsettling, you didn't know how to do it, and you feel like your mind wanders, the Sync Tuition is awesome. We do it before bed, but you can do it anytime. Again, 25 minutes of the Sync Tuition, and each day it's a different one, is 4 hours of meditation. And the studies about meditation and strengthening the body and healing the body is overwhelming. And it goes back almost 3,000 years. So you really want to take that seriously, especially if you feel like you can't budget for any supplements right now. Then do that. Again, work on the sleeping, cleaning up indoor air pollution, and your breathing exercises or your meditation or your prayer time. Strengthen that. It's free, so there you go. But if you do have some money in your budget for some supplements, I want to stress quality. Once again, you definitely want to buy from someone that you trust, and you want to buy quality, okay? Because if you buy a supplement that isn't what it promises to be, you'll hurt yourself more than help yourself. And I am going to mention one that really bothers me, and that is Activia. So if anyone's using it, I just want you to do your homework. All you have to do is Google the ingredients to get the information I'm about to tell you. So it is made from animal strain bacteria that comes from the feces of certain animals like rats, chicken, what's the other one? Not good thing animals. Like, I always think of which animals it is, and it's like the Activia animals are just, I mean, I don't know. I have nothing against rats, but I don't really want to ingest rat poop. Now, animal strain bacteria is being used for people's health. And so I'm not saying that it's totally bad, but it's not a human strain bacteria. So it only helps you as you're using it. As soon as you stop, your digestive malfunction comes back. And Dannon, the people that own Activia, they're the ones that have this information. There is no third-party study that was done for Activia. It's all in-house. And all the other ingredients are sugar, artificial colors, modified food starch, glycerin, cellulose, things that you don't want to put in the human body for health. So you're getting an animal strain feces, and then you're getting all these artificial ingredients that do not benefit our health. But they spend millions on marketing. If they spent all that money on actually making a good product, then that would be awesome. But all their money goes into marketing and tricking you. So please be smarter than that. If you see a lot of hype when it comes to commercials, marketing, and claims, look into it. Just do a little bit of homework. But the first thing in a supplement that will improve your health is good bacteria. So choose wisely. At my store, I only sell 2 brands of good bacteria. because those are the only ones that I really used with myself and my customers and my family that I saw a benefit right away that was affordable, really good quality. So you definitely want to choose wisely. But good bacteria, when it goes into the gut, it's amazing what it does. It produces B vitamins, and when you have natural produced B vitamins inside your gut, you get more energy, you get control of your stress levels, you eliminate toxins out of whether it be urine or feces much more efficiently. Your cells, when they die off and make new cells, you make a stronger, healthier cell. They're calling the gut our second brain. I would say that sounds pretty darn important. So in this second brain, this gut, it has enzymes that unlock and make everything happen in the human body. So if your gut health is not under control, then you know the central, you know, control board of the body is going to go wrong. It's not going to communicate properly to all the organ systems, to every cell. So that is where your first focus should be. Just like I mentioned in the beginning of the show, when you go to build a home, you're not going to talk about the walls until you get that foundation level, really strong concrete. You know, you're going to get the barbed wire through it. You're going to frame it perfectly square. You're not going to start with something that's shaky, because then why put anything else into your home if it's just going to fall apart? So gut health is that foundation. That's that most important step. And again, if you don't want to buy a supplement, that's okay. You can do it with good fermented foods. Kimchi, which is sold in all our supermarkets here locally, is awesome. It's a little spicy, but you can, just do a little bit a day, just a tablespoon. But it's full of lots of natural, amazing bacteria that your body will just take in and utilize. Sauerkrauts, kefir without the sugar. So again, don't get the ones that are heavily made with sugars or artificial colors or flavors. But those are just some of the great fermented foods or cultured foods that will naturally help repair your gut. So probiotic is the first thing on my list, supplement-wise, to make your body healthy against cold and flu season. The next one is elderberry. I've seen elderberry everywhere. About 2 years ago, there was a shortage on elderberry. And no joke, I had people like pounding down my door trying to find some. It not only is awesome for cold and flus, but it tastes so good that it's family friendly. A lot of cold and flu remedies don't taste very good. Some of the soups that they suggest or the teas they suggest, they might be fine for the adults, but a lot of kids don't like it. But kids usually love elderberry. Garden of Life makes a delicious, delicious elderberry chewy gummy. I sell it all the time. As everyone knows, I have Garden of Life at 20% off every day. It's extremely affordable, tastes good, super clean, no artificial ingredients. But elderberries, people really in the beginning just used them because they helped with inflammation. They had a lot of vitamin C naturally in it. And vitamin C is pretty much like the pioneer of supplementation. You know, Linus Pauling taught us that with vitamin C, we get our immune system strong. We fight anything that's coming at our cells. And elderberry just happens to be really high in vitamin C. But that's not the whole story. It has so many antioxidants and special ingredients that it will definitely fight any free radicals, which is the bad guys in the body. It fights the free radicals to make the cells stronger. So that way, when the bacteria and the virus come to attack, it makes a stronger line of defense. So elderberry actually has studies against cold and flus, totally natural. It's just this little beautiful purple berry, and it tastes good. So definitely give elderberry a try. You can buy it usually in gummies or syrups. The syrups sometimes are better for the little ones because if you've ever seen a child that didn't like something, they would just like taste it and then hide it under the couch. So the syrup, you know, you can just drip in a little teaspoon real quick and get it over with. But the flavor, if it's natural, it just tastes like if they were eating a blackberry or a raspberry to me. So definitely give elderberry a try. And it's not just for colds and flus. People use it for hay fever, constipation, urine flow, heart disease, high cholesterol, headaches, toothaches, even for weight loss. So definitely give elderberry a try. And if you took too much, like if you're like me and absolutely love the taste of the gummies and you keep just popping them in your mouth, it's okay. There are no side effects with elderberry and it would never hurt you. So another advantage of using natural supplementation versus drugs. The next product I would definitely consider keeping in the house, and again, you want to either use this preventively or the first sign of any bodily change to an immune system that's compromised. Your temperature's changing, you feel a fatigue or a muscle ache or your eyes are itchy. Anything that shows differently than your normal day-to-day body behavior, you definitely want to start vamping up the immune system. Do not wait until you're really sick. So the next is silver. Silver is an antiviral. Colloidal silver is the way that most stores sell the product. You can get liquids, you can get nasal spray bottles, you can get general spray bottles. I love the spray bottles because I feel like wherever my body needs the silver sprayed, whether it be my eyes, my ears, my nose, my mouth, it's super easy to use. But whatever your choice is, it's extremely affordable. Colloidal silver has been out a long time now, definitely showing it's safe with the right brand. So again, you want to go with someone you can trust. I sell Sovereign Silver. Sovereign Silver has been around a super long time. They have an amazing website that goes into detail about all their products. They make a pet formula, a children's formula, and Sovereign Silver is great, especially if you feel like something's in your throat. I always would do elderberry every day because I love the taste, but silver has no flavor. So again, great for kids. And you can just spray it in your mouth as soon as there's any sign of where your throat's being strained, you have a little tickle in the back of your throat, definitely start that silver right away. And if you come in the store, we can tell you exactly how to use the silver. I have lots of different tricks that I use with the silver and my family. All right, time is going fast, so I want to really move quickly to make sure I cover everything that you should try. Okay, there is one really super cool study that it can kill over 650 different disease-causing pathogens, the silver. There's a lot of places that use silver to clean instruments or counters where there might be germs or microbes that are dangerous to the human body. So you definitely want to think about the silver that way, because the antibiotics have become to the point where now our body is resistant to all of them. They're not working anymore. Where silver, that doesn't happen. It doesn't work the same way as antibiotics, where our body, you know, makes these super bugs, you know, that the silver can't kill. The silver right now is still killing everything that's at least coming my way, my family's way, my customer's way. So definitely keep considering using silver. Now is vitamin D3. I know all my listeners are very well versed with D3, and especially if you're a Floridian, the sun does make our own bodies make vitamin D3. But they say because of sunscreen that's very chemicalized, not being out in fresh air enough, we are not getting enough D3 and we are extremely deficient in it. which to me, you know, living in Florida, it's like crazy to think we're deficient, but we are. Most of my customers come in after blood tests and show that their vitamin D3 levels are very low. And D3 is such an inexpensive supplement. It's you can get 3 months worth for $10. And they're usually either chewable or tiny little pills, or I have D3 that comes from food that's a spray that's vanilla flavored. So whatever you have to do, you want to try to get at least 2,000 IUs in a vitamin D3 a day. And if you're not feeling well or you're immune compromised, it should be 5,000 IUs a day. There are some doctors that after you get blood tests, they will put you on huge high doses for a short time to get your levels normalized. I've never agreed with that thinking. I believe that you will throw something off balance if you take too much of one thing in nature. You never find anything that's that high in vitamin D3. So again, go out in early morning sun or late day sun without any chemicalized sunscreen on. Take a nice brisk walk to get that D3 in you naturally. Do the 5,000, maybe tops 10,000 D3, and your body will get stronger each and every day and bring it back into balance. But I definitely don't believe in doing these high mega doses. Unfortunately, you know, they were the same people that said D3 was toxic not too long ago, and now they're saying do extreme high doses. So just stay conservative with it and just do healthy lifestyle choices like getting early day sun, and your body will come into balance all by itself. It's just an amazing thing, our bodies. All right, so the next one is oregano oil. Now, I absolutely love oregano oil, and my family does too. But I remember the first days I started using it with my children. The taste is super strong. The faces they will give you are priceless, so get your cameras ready to, like, film it. But oregano, even the smell, you can tell it's going to kill something. It's so overwhelmingly strong, smell-wise and strength-wise. It really kills all the bugs and the germs and the things that might bother the human body, and extremely safe. I think of it as a natural antibiotic. After I do oil pulling, I'll put a couple drops into my mouth, feeling that if the oil pulling left anything left behind in my mouth, it will kill it. There's really no reason not to have it in the home and to use it periodically. Some holistic practitioners will say, just like an antibiotic, do it on and off, maybe do, 5 days of a month just to really kick your body into gear, make it stronger, kill any unwelcome visitors in the human body. But really, the oregano, it can be used every day. It's totally safe. It's just expensive if you use it every day. So choose wisely how you and your family want to use it. But I am telling you, even if you use one drop each day, you will definitely have better health. It is proven that your oral health reflects the rest of your body. So to put one drop in to help the roots of, the roots of your teeth, dental work is super expensive, but that bacteria can cause deadly problems when it goes right into your mucosa lining, which is right there in your teeth. So really try that oregano oil. There's so many different versions that you can buy. I love the brand North American. I have sold North American oregano oil for about 30 years, and I can trust it. They have really high quality, and they are the ones that brought all the research to the community to bring their awareness that you can use things like sage and oregano oil, black seed oil. These are the people that taught us this, and now everyone's getting on the bandwagon. So if you really want to trust the quality, I would go with North American. I mentioned using essential oils, really critical, but food as well. You can go right to your grocery store and buy things that will prevent and treat the flu. Ginger, garlic, lemon, and cayenne pepper. If you make a soup or a tea or any concoction out of those ingredients, so again, garlic, ginger, lemon, cayenne pepper, those are amazing to get that immune system kicking up strong and getting the flu out of your body. I tell people if they can handle that taste, you can put a little raw honey. But unfortunately, a lot of the honey that is produced in our country isn't true local raw honey. It's pasteurized, it's processed, it's made with syrups that aren't even honey. So then you're putting sugar in your body, which is one of the cause of immune failure. So you want to use local raw honey that you trust in this concoction if you want to make it taste a little more pleasant, especially if it's for little ones. And the last but not least, the most important thing is to keep hybrid CR in your home. I have been selling hybrid CR for almost 5 years now. The creator is an immunologist that worked for the Mayo Clinic, and this stuff is incredible. It's super inexpensive. It's less than $20. It's this little blue box called Hybrid CR. I'm sure all the local health food stores are selling it now. And you basically keep it in your cupboard. At the first sign you start taking this, it's 4 days. And I am telling you, you'll take a flu that might last 2 weeks down to 3 days, but you just take all 4 days because it makes sure that all the bad guys are gone out of your body. I talk super fast that last page, but sometimes I feel like all of a sudden Cliff tells me show's over and I didn't get all the info in. So
you've still got a whole minute.
Wow, a whole minute. I can catch my breath. Whoo! Yeah. All right, everyone. So the first line of defense is always positive, positive thoughts. Be aware, but prevention is key. Get that sleep, drink that water, take time to breathe, and appreciate the day. Appreciate today. And so Dr. Ravi will be with you guys next week. So I'll see you in a couple weeks. Have a great end of month.
It's all quite easy. Drink your water, get your rest, breathe.
Super easy.
Super all natural. You've been listening to Joanne's World of Nutrition, presented by Joanne's Nutrition World, US 1, across from Fort Pierce City Hall in the historic Arcade Building, US 1 between Orange Avenue and Avenue A in Fort Pierce. This is WPSL Port St. Lucie, the talk of the Treasure Coast, Dr. Stuart Shipe's Holistic Health Hour. Follow CBS News. The time right now is 11 o'clock.